Next topic is physical and chemical changes. In previous chapter, we have learned about some physical properties of matter. The properties that can be observed and specified like color, hardness, rigidity, fluidity, density, melting point, boiling point, etc. are all physical properties of matter. The interconversion of a state is a physical change because these changes occur without a change in composition and no changes in the chemical nature of the substance. Although ice, water and water vapor all look different and display different physical properties, they are chemically the same. Both water and cooking oil are liquid, but their chemical characteristics are different. They differ in odor and inflammability. We know that oil burns in air, whereas water extinguishes fire. It is the chemical property of oil that makes different from water. Burning is a chemical change, and during this undergo a change in chemical composition. Thus, we can say that the chemical changes bring changes in the chemical properties of matter and we get a new substance. A chemical change is also known as chemical reaction. Okay, so we can say that those type of reaction in which if the composition of, if the property of substance are not changed, okay, throughout same in this reaction, okay, are said to be physical change, like interconversion of states of matter, okay. So these are said to be physical changes, okay. But when we talk about chemical changes, then those type of reaction in which the property of the composition of substance get changed and new product formed, then they are said to be chemical changes. So this is the basic concept of physical and chemical changes, okay. Now you have to focus on these questions. You have to focus on these questions which are given here. Classify the following as the chemical, physical properties or changes. We have cutting of trees, melting of butter in a pan, rusting of almira, boiling of water to form steam, passing of electric current through water and the water breaking down the hydrogen and oxygen gas, dissolving common salt in water, making the fruit salad with the raw fruits, burning of paper and wood. So we have to differentiate all these things on the basis of their changes. Either they are physical changes or chemical changes. You have to do with yourself. Okay. Now let us proceed to another topic, which is what are the types of pure substance. On the basis of their chemical composition, substances can be classified either elements or compounds. Okay. So we know that if the substance are made up of single type of atom, then they are said to be elements. And if the substance are made up of more than two type of atom, more than two kinds of atom, or two more than elements are said to be compound. For example, hydrogen is made up of only hydrogen atom, oxygen is made up of only oxygen atom, then it's said to be element. But when we talk about compound, means H2O, H2O is a compound. How? H2O means water is made up of atoms of hydrogen and atoms of oxygen, okay, the combination of the atoms of hydrogen and oxygen, thus H2O is a compound. So basically substances classified among these two types. Now let us talk about elements. Robert Boyle was the first scientist to use this term, which is element, in 1961. Antoni Laurent Lavoisier, which is born in 1743 and dead in 1794, a French chemist, was the first to establish the experiment useful in definition of an element, and he defined an element as a basis of the form of the matter that cannot be broken down into simpler substance as a chemical reaction. Okay, so when you break any
element that convert into itself only. Okay, you convert any compound, break any compound, then it convert into their constituent, like H2O, which break down into hydrogen and oxygen. But when you break down hydrogen, it convert into again hydrogen, it convert into again hydrogen. Okay, so elements can be normally divided into two types, metal and non-metal, and there is another one type which is known as metalloids. Okay, so metals, non-metals and metalloids. Okay, so the property of metal and non-metal are studied from a long time, long ago.
Earlier classes we already discuss about it. Okay,
we discuss about the property of metals, like they are luster, they have silvery gray and golden yellow color, they conduct electricity and heat, they are ductile, can be drawn into wire, they are malleable, can be hammered into the thin sheet, they are sonorous, making a ringing sound from heat, when he hit. The example of metal are gold, silver, copper, iron, sodium, potassium. Mercury is the only metal that can be formed in liquid, but basically metals are generally solids. Okay, non-metals are usually just opposite to the property of solid. Okay, and those type of substance having both property of metals and non-metal, they are said to be metalloids. Some example of non-metal like hydrogen, oxygen, iodine, carbon, bromine, etc. And some elements of the intermediate properties between those metals and non-metals, they are said to be metalloids. For example, bronze, silicon and germanium, these are the elements having both property of metals and non-metals. So this is all about metals, non-metals and metalloids. Okay, let us talk about a few line about compounds. A compound is a substance composed of two or more elements chemically combined with one another in a fixed proportion. Okay, so this is all about elements and compound. Okay, in your book, page number in 26, the differences are given.
Differences in mixture and compound, you have to write down in your copy and remember it. Okay,
some bullet points are given in page number 26. You have to read and understand what is given. Okay, and thus this chapter is completed. You need to summarize this chapter, and I hope you are writing your notes in very good manner. Whatever I taught you during classes, you have to write down in your notebook and make a perfect notes that help you in upcoming examination of school and obtain highest marks. So you have to make your notes of chapter 1 and chapter 2 and also chapter 8 and chapter 9. Okay, so we finish fourth chapter in your science textbook, which are, I repeat, matter in our surrounding, chapter 1, chapter 2 is matter around us pure, chapter 8 motion, and chapter 9 force and laws of motion. Okay, so these chapters are finished. In next lecture we start a new chapter. Okay, so I want to tell you, please make your notes of these four chapter whatever we completed during these classes, online classes, and please remember it. Okay.